Stellar explosions are an amazingly rare thing. According to our best estimates, such events only occur in our galaxy once every 50 years. It's only recently, thanks to ongoing improvements in instrumentation and technology, that astronomers have been able to observe such events taking place. As of yet, no one ever has witnessed this phenomenon in action, but that may be about to change. Scientists speculate that there may be a terrifying star explosion in 2022 that will be visible to the naked eye. Let's take a closer look at this supernova and what we can expect to see. A supernova is what happens when a star has reached the end of its life and explodes in a brilliant burst of light. Supernovae can briefly outshine entire galaxies and radiate more energy than our sun will in its entire lifetime. They're also the primary source of heavy elements in the universe. According to NASA, supernovae are the largest explosion that takes place in space. Various civilizations recorded supernovae long before the telescope was invented in the 17th century. The oldest recorded supernova is RCW 86, which Chinese astronomers spotted in AD 185. According to NASA, records show that this guest star stayed in the sky for 8 months. The Crab Nebula, arguably the most famous supernova, was first spotted by Chinese and Korean astronomers who recorded this star explosion in their records in 1054. Native Americans may have seen it as well, according to rock paintings found in Arizona and New Mexico. The supernova that formed the Crab Nebula was so bright that those early astronomers could see it during the day. Other supernovae that were observed before the telescope was invented occurred in the years 393, 1006, 1181, 1572, and 1604. Famed astronomer Tycho Brahe, who observed the 1572 event, wrote about his observations of the new star in his book, De Nova Stella, which gave rise to the name Nova. The term supernova was first used by Walter Body and Fritz Zwicky at Mount Wilson Observatory, who used it concerning an explosive event they observed called S. Andromedae, located in the Andromeda Galaxy. The scientists suggested that supernovas happen when ordinary stars collapse into neutron stars. According to research by the European Space Agency, on average, a supernova will occur once every 50 years in a galaxy the size of the Milky Way. The U.S. Department of Energy estimates that a star explodes every 10 seconds or so somewhere in the universe. About 10 million years ago, a cluster of supernovae created the local bubble, a 300 light-year long, peanut-shaped bubble of gas in the interstellar medium that surrounds our solar system. Exactly how a star dies depends in part on its mass. One sun, for example, doesn't have enough mass to explode as a supernova, but with the right amount of mass, a star can burn out in a fiery explosion. A supernova may occur in one of two ways. In a Type 1 supernova, a star accumulates matter from a nearby neighbor until a runaway nuclear reaction ignites. A Type 2 supernova happens when a star runs out of nuclear fuel and collapses under its gravity. A Type 2 supernova is arguably the more exciting of the two. For a star to explode as a Type 2 supernova, it must be several times more massive than the Sun, and estimates run from 8 to 15 solar masses. Like the Sun, it will eventually run out of hydrogen and then helium fuel at its core. However, it will have enough mass and pressure to fuse carbon. Next, gradually heavier elements build up at the center, and the star forms onion-like layers of material, with elements becoming lighter toward the outside of the star. Once the star's core surpasses a certain mass, it begins to implode. For this reason, these Type 2 supernovae are also known as core collapse supernovae. Eventually, the implosion bounces back off the core, expelling the stellar material into space, forming the supernova. What's left is an ultra-dense object called a neutron star, a city-sized object that packs the mass of the Sun in a small space. Type 2 supernova subcategories are classified based on their light curves, which describe how the intensity of the light changes over time. The light of Type 2 L supernovae declines steadily after the explosion, while the light of Type 2 P supernovae stays steady for a longer period of time before diminishing. Both types have the signature of hydrogen in their spectra. Astronomers think that stars much more massive than the Sun might not explode as a supernova. Instead, they collapse to form black holes. Type 1 supernovae lack a hydrogen signature in their light spectra and are generally thought to originate from white dwarf stars and a close binary star system. As the gas of the companion star accumulates into the white dwarf is progressively compressed and sets off a runaway nuclear reaction inside that eventually leads to a cataclysmic supernova outburst. Astronomers use Type 1A supernovae as standard candles to measure cosmic distances because all are thought to blaze with equal brightness at their peaks. Type 1B and 1C supernovae also undergo core collapse just as Type 2 supernovae do, but they have lost much of their outer hydrogen layer. In 2014, scientists detected the faint, hard-to-locate companion star to a Type 1B supernova. The search consumed 2 decades, as the companion star shone much fainter than the bright supernova. Recent studies have found that supernovae vibrate like giant speakers and emit an audible hum before exploding. In 2008, scientists caught a supernova in the act of exploding for the first time. While peering at her computer screen, astronomer Alicia Soderberg expected to see the small glowing smudge of a month-old supernova. But what she and her colleagues saw instead was a strange, extremely bright, 5-minute burst of X-rays. With that observation, they became the first astronomers to catch a star in the act of exploding. The new supernova was named SN 2008D. Further study has shown that the supernova had some unusual properties that are being studied to this day. Latest reports suggest that a new supernova event may happen in 2022 that will be visible to the naked eye, giving astronomers hope for answers. NASA's iconic Hubble Space Telescope has recently spotted a star that survived the violent death of its companion. Using the telescope's Wide Field Camera 3, researchers were able to study the supernova, dubbed SN 2013 GE, in ultraviolet light. The scientists found that while the light from the bright stellar explosion has been fading since 2016, another nearby source of ultraviolet light has maintained its brightness over time, suggesting SN 2013 GE has a surviving binary companion. Using the Hubble data, astronomers were able to identify the signature of various elements in the supernova explosion. Strangely, no hydrogen was detected in the region of SN 2013 GE, leaving scientists to guess how the gas might have been stripped away before the explosion occurred. The observation shed some new light on the nature of massive stars in binary systems. Observations of SN 2013 GE also help explain how some stars are stripped of their hydrogen pre-supernova, which, in this case, is the result of an unseen stellar companion siphoning gas from its partner before it explodes. Astronomers can now use SN 2013 GE's surviving companion to better understand the characteristics of the star that exploded, which has since become a compact object, such as a neutron star or black hole. The companion star will likely experience a similar fate, given that it, too, is a massive star. Now the researchers will be able to track the surviving star's evolution. Depending on the distance between the original companion stars, the surviving partner will either be flung out of the system, which could help explain why solitary supernovae are observed across the universe, or continue orbiting its companion before merging to create gravitational waves. However, such an event would not occur for 1 billion years. Understanding the life cycle of massive stars is particularly important to scientists because all heavy elements are forged in their cores and through their supernovae. These elements make up much of the observable universe. Scientists believe that studying these explosions in the sky can help us better understand the nature of the universe and how it all began. About 4 years ago, a study predicted that in 2022, 2 stars would merge, leading to a colossal explosion in the sky. This was the first-of-its-kind prediction of a red nova that would be visible even to the naked eye. Humanity has recorded 8 naked-eye supernovas in the past 2,000 years, the latest being Supernova 1987A and the Large Magellanic Cloud, one of the Milky Way's neighboring galaxies. The light from the supernova reached our planet on February 23, 1987, and it was the first supernova that modern astronomers were able to study in great detail. Since the prediction, there has been much speculation if a red nova will indeed be visible in the sky. In the literal sense, the word nova means a new star. Ancient civilizations considered these events as the creation of a new star. However, in reality, novae are the explosions that occur on the surface of the stars near the end of their lives. Consider a binary system consisting of a white dwarf and a main sequence star. A main sequence star is fusing hydrogen to helium inside its core, just like the Sun. On the other hand, a white dwarf is a stellar remnant, a dead star composed mainly of electron-degenerate matter. On average, the white dwarf's mass is comparable to the sun's mass, and its volume is similar to Earth's. This makes white dwarfs very dense astronomical objects. So, in a binary system consisting of a white dwarf and a main sequence star, the white dwarf star, more massive and denser, pulls out material from the main sequence star. And when enough material builds upon the surface of the white dwarf, it triggers an explosion that we call a red nova. For a limited moment, this system can light up to a million times brighter than its average luminosity. The white dwarf can generate nova outbursts at periodic intervals as long as it continues to consume gas from its partner star. The red novae have a characteristic red tint that sets them apart from the other novae. Unfortunately, this prediction that we will be able to observe this event with a naked eye this year seems to be false. The story began in 2013 when Professor Larry Molnar from Calvin College and his team began analyzing a pair of tightly bound stars known as KIC 983-2227, located in the constellation Cygnus, about 1,800 light years away from us. They observed strange blips in the brightness of the stars, hinting that the two stars were periodically blotting each other out. Upon looking at the data, astronomers suggested that the two stars were on a collision course that would happen at some point in 2022, causing a red nova in the sky. However, various teams began working on validating and checking the accuracy of the nova prediction at the same time, and this is when unwelcome news arrived. In 2018, while analyzing the archival data, a group from San Diego State University spotted a typographical error in the archived orbit of the stars. The time of an observed eclipse was mistranscribed by precisely 12 hours in the publication, and it was because of this unintentional blunder that Molnar's calculations regarding the timing of future eclipses were incorrect. When this typo was corrected, it no longer predicted the stars of the binary system to merge and produce a rare red nova. Although this news is heartbreaking to astronomers everywhere, history shows us that it is only a matter of time before such an event takes place again. If you like this video, please also consider taking a look at this one, which details the most frightening space events that will happen in 2022. Do you think a supernova visible to the naked eye will happen in our lifetime? Please share your thoughts in the comments section below.